Hey guys, welcome to my last baby update. As you can see, something has changed. Yesterday I got a haircut and I chopped all of my hair off. It was past my boobs, it was very long, and it feels so nice to just not worry about my hair and getting in the way of like breastfeeding. It is so annoying when you're breastfeeding, leaning over and then like hair is like falling on your baby. So then you have to like deal with your hair, you have to deal with breastfeeding, you have to deal with the cover, you have to deal with all these things. And then if you have your hair up because it's so long in a bun, then it's like always in a bun and you just always feel grubby kind of. I don't know, that's me personally. So I like that I chopped it. It's very, very short right now. I'm excited for it to grow kind of to here. I think it'll be a little bit easier to curl and less afro-like because it's kind of like bleep. Anyways, that's new, and I got that right before babies come. I wanted to touch base with you guys to let you know what's happening based on my previous baby update video, because I got a lot of bad news in that video, a lot of scary news and a lot of like unanswered questions in that video. It was just a lot all at once and nothing was answered. So I got a lot of testing done and it confirmed that I do need a C-section. So I guess I'll talk a little bit about my thoughts on the C-section, because last video, I know I was like super emotional on camera. I promised myself that I would not cry on this video, so hopefully I don't cry, because I feel like I cry with every video that you guys see. My thoughts on the C-section, I'm trying to stay more positive and not think of all of the complications that can happen, because I feel as though that doesn't help me. It doesn't help with babies. I could be just causing myself more stress when it can go smoothly, so we'll just act on what happens when it happens. I'm trying to focus on the positive things, like meeting my babies. So I feel like sometimes, like, it's gonna be a different experience for sure of having a scheduled C-section, because you don't need to go through exhaustion of labor for like hours on end. Obviously for like 10 plus hours if you're doing like vaginal or whatever, but even if you did 6 hours of labor and then you had to get like switched out to emergency C-section, like you still had to heal from basically two different types of birth in that case. And I'm kind of grateful that I get a scheduled C-section, because I can go in there and it can be calm environment. I can be like freshly nude with sleep. I know with Theo, he was like 11 hours-ish. I couldn't sit down for the entire time. I was so exhausted. I couldn't sleep the entire time. And then after you have this baby, you have to take care of this baby. Whereas I feel like a C-section, especially with like my situation, they might take the babies away and they might like want to do some monitoring and things. So I might have time to sleep and recover a little bit, which is really, really nice. Obviously C-section, there's like healing, different type, and my friend said it's really painful, cough and laugh and stuff. So that'll be interesting. I'm just more worried about like the surgery itself. Also, it'll be so nice to have my body back, and not in the sense of like bounce back and be skinny. I don't care about that. I'm losing my second and third kid. I don't care. I'm talking about like these little beings taking up space in my body. I just want my own body and to worry about my own body. Not be kicked in the ribs. Pregnant women out there understand what I mean. Have like, you're sharing your space. That's your space. And I'm excited to get them out and just to have my space all to myself. Also, I'm excited to see my feet, because when I stand up, they disappear. Or my child. Sometimes I bump into him and I'm like, where'd you go? And I'm hoping I get a call tomorrow from a nurse that's gonna give me more details on who can be in the room with me and if we can do like a gentle cesarean, which is where you kind of control a little bit of the elements. So you play a little bit of light music and you dim the lights, sort of things like that to like relax me so I don't have a panic attack on the table. And if Shane's allowed, how it like works in the hospital with their rules, I don't know, because they constantly are changing their rules because of COVID. Also, thank you to everybody who watched my video, sent me a prayer. That was very, very sweet and made my day. So thank you so much for that. The cholestasis thing that I mentioned before, the itching, I don't have that. So that's awesome. That test came back negative. And then I got a stress test or a non-stress test done to monitor to see how the babies are doing. They were more worried about the girl, as you know, in the last video, that's what I said, is the girl's weight. Turns out it's actually the boy's weight that they're worried about. So the girl's weight, for any of you parents, you guys know about this chart, but for anybody who doesn't have to worry about kids, it's this chart that pediatricians use where it shows what kind of curve line the kid chose to like grow on. So basically the girl, she had a growth spurt and then she dropped a curve line. So a percentile for people talking about kids. And then she's consistently growing in this curve line. So that's not too bad. A lot of kids sometimes drop or go on a higher one. That's fine if it's consistent over time. But the boy at first, he had like a big jump and then he dropped and then he dropped and then he dropped. Now that doesn't mean he's dropping in weight. It just means that he's dropping in percentile and he's not following any curve. So that's concerning to them and they want to get him out so they can monitor and make sure that he chooses a curve line. So I am 35 weeks and 5 days currently as I'm filming this. But when my C-section is going to happen is on Monday, the 27th of September, and I will be 36 weeks and 2 days pregnant when the babies come out. So I'm hoping that that gives them a little bit of time to gain enough weight that we won't be in the NICU very long. They'll probably want to monitor them for a bit, but if they're a good weight, we should be able to take them home within 2 or 3 days. So on Monday, the ultrasound said that the boy was 5 pounds 9 ounces and the girl was 4 pounds 14 ounces. They're really close to 5 and I'm really hoping that by the 27th they will be she'll be above 5 pounds and then he'll be around 6. I'm hoping. Who knows? Sometimes the ultrasounds are like way off on weight. My sister, her son was off like a full pound. They were like, whoa, he's small. And then my cousin had her daughter and they were saying that her head's gonna be like huge, huge head. She had a normal head. I don't know if they're gonna be off or not, but I'm really, really hoping that they're above the 5 pound mark just so that they don't get in the way that's pretty. So another thing that they were concerned about that the tests actually showed. So I got an NST, which is a non-stress test. And then I got a ultrasound, but it wasn't a regular ultrasound. It was looked at by a special doctor that is a OBGYN, I think OBGYN, and radiologist. So they're very specialized. And here in Alberta, they do this hospital. So the Royal Alex Hospital does all of Northern Alberta and then some of the Northwest Territory. So they're really, really busy. The Lois Hole Clinic, that's an all-women's clinic. It has everything to do with women. They get all sorts of births. They get a lot of abnormalities, some twin cases, unless you have a private practice, like my OB is private practice. And then they do all triplets. So they're super busy. So when I went for my ultrasound, I waited like 5 hours. But as soon as they do the ultrasound, then the doctor looks it over and then comes to you right away. You don't leave and then hear later your results. She actually comes in the room and like actually goes really thoroughly through the results. So she told me they caught it's not really a problem, but it could potentially cause a problem. The girl has a skip beat in her heart. So every so often a beat is skipped and they said that some kids have that and they grow out of it. She doesn't have any abnormalities of her heart. It looks like beautiful, just all the valves work and all the chambers and stuff. So they aren't really too concerned about it, but it's nice to know. And then today I actually went for another NST, a non-stress test, and we noticed you could clearly hear that skip beat. It was consistent. So that's also something that they will have to watch when they bring out the babies, is the girl. They'll probably want to monitor her heart and see if it's something that they need to be concerned about or not. Right now it's Thursday that I'm recording this, and it's Monday that we're gonna have a C-section, so we are getting ready for the twins. Not much really we need to do. I did a lot of it. I just need to get the van ready and put in the car seats and everything. So also, by the time that you guys are watching this, it will be after I have the babies. So we're a little bit behind. But if you follow me on Instagram, I'll be posting things and keeping you guys up to date, like, immediately on what's going on. Also, the next few videos after this one is released will probably be a little bit older. They will be ones that I've filmed currently pregnant and that I've stocked up on, just so we have time to kind of be with babies and not worry about filming and editing and uploading a video. They will be a little bit older, so if I say I'm currently this week pregnant, because they're older videos. Also, let me know what you guys want to see regarding the twins. If you guys want to see, like, more face-to-face videos that I've been doing, or if you guys want to see more, like, day in the life of what it's like to have newborn twins, or what kind of videos you guys want to see, let me know in the comments below. Last, heads up for more videos. Once the twins are born, I plan on doing a birth vlog video, and I want to do a meet the babies / name reveal video, so if you guys are curious about the names. Also, I want to do a video of Theo meeting the babies the first time, so if you guys haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. You are welcome. Everybody's welcome, and stay tuned for those videos in the future. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Stay tuned for what is to come. Honestly, I haven't grown super, super big with this pregnancy as I thought I would. I thought, like, you see people with, like, multiples and their bellies are huge, and I feel like my belly isn't that big compared to what other people's is. Also, I haven't even hit the weight that I hit when I gave birth to Theo. So that's really interesting that I have, like, double the amount of baby and not as much weight.